Simpsons or on the Sunday shows? Oh, yes, they talk about how many troops are lined up against NATO and that sort of thing. I'm not talking about that sort of thing. And the ideologues, well, they're in full-throated attack. The ideologues who talk about the neocons and the federal contractors. And the others, the isolationists who go on and on about how we're provoking our enemies. War is not about ideology. Foreign policy is not about ideology. National security is not about ideology. The word that describes it best is prudence. Prudence. The wise judgment brought to very difficult decisions, facts, and issues. That's what we expect from our leaders. Tell me, does the Department of Defense, with the Secretary of Defense and the head of the Joint Chiefs, do they seem like the very best people in a position to protect this country and safeguard this country? Should there be a war? How about the Secretary of State? Does he seem like the very best person to use diplomacy to rally our allies and defend off our enemies? How about the National Security Advisor? Do you know who the National Security Advisor is? He was an operative prior to serving in his current position. He was also involved in the dirty tricks to try and take out former President Trump with respect to Russia collusion. How about Congress? Is this not the weakest Congress we've seen in the modern era? Not a lot of smart people in Congress. Not a lot of people who look at their country first. You look at our country, ladies and gentlemen, we're at each other's throats. Why are we at each other's throats? Because of this American Marxist movement that seeks to destroy our history, support for our country as it is today, and in our classrooms, on the border, with budgets, violating separation of powers, you name it, just turning the culture inside out. Is Hollywood on our side? Is corporate America on our side? Or are they just too invested in communist China and other regimes that have designs on this country? And the United States military, the infantry, the Air Force, the Marines, and so forth, you think they're being trained properly? In many respects, they are. But what about critical race theory, transgenderism, and other events, radical left events, that take up way too much of their time and demoralize them? And what about the commander-in-chief? Is he up to the job? The answer to all of this is a disastrous domestic situation facing a grave foreign policy situation. And there's very little prudence involved. And that is a big, big problem. So as we're fighting over the Voting Rights Act, which has nothing to do with voting rights, and the rest of the American Marxist Democrat Party media academic agenda, none of it has anything to do with strengthening the United States military, our national security, and ultimately our self-preservation. None of it. If we had a real media in this country, you'd understand what's taking place overseas. So we have to ignore the loudmouth ideologues who are endless interventionists and the loudmouth ideologues who seem to believe that hypersonic missiles, intercontinental ballistic missiles, nuclear warheads, stealth fighters, and so forth, once they reach the American border, they stop. They're not a threat anymore. Now, we are in a serious pickle here, you might say. Now, whose fault is this? Well, obviously, it's the enemy's fault. Who's the enemy? Well, there's even debate over this. So much of our culture has been bought off by the communist Chinese regime, you can't even say anything like the China virus. Say the Spanish virus, to talk about a white dominant society. But of course, when you talk about the communist Chinese regime, that's what it is. But you're not allowed to talk about that. So how can you talk seriously about it? When it comes to Putin, there's some kind of a love, bizarre relationship between Putin and a certain percentage of our politicos in this country and media, who seem to think he's a pretty cool guy, he's a tough guy, and so forth. No, he's a killer. He's a killer who killed his way to the top. He's corrupt. He wants to hold on to power. And he wants to reestablish the old Soviet Union, which was defeated during the Cold War by Reagan and the United States and our allies. Why should we defend the Ukraine? Oh, I don't know. Why should we defend Belgium, Italy, France, Great tourism started in Lawrence, Kansas. I don't know of any, do you? How many wars? In Joplin, Missouri. None that I can think of. No. The wars were overseas. They had a way of reaching into the United States. The fact of the matter is, China, Russia, they're not alone, are building militaries against us. Russia's not building a military against Ukraine. They don't need all that hardware, all that technology, all those troops just for Ukraine. China's not building the biggest navy, killer satellites, and so forth, because of Taiwan. They're building them because of us. Us, the United States of America. Do we act as a government like we're serious about confronting this? Do we act as a government like we need to become more reliant on our own manufacturing and our own products? Do we act as a government that we need to secure the border and make sure the United States is safe from within? Do we act as a government that we use our financial priorities wisely, not redistributing wealth, not creating new massive entitlements, not breaking the back of the American taxpayer, but ensuring that our military has everything it needs to potentially fight more than a one-region war? This is very, very serious business, ladies and gentlemen. The hackers and the hawkers and the soapbox loudmouths are not the people to listen to. AOC does not have any experience when it comes to the military, and most of the people in the Senate don't either. But we, the people, one day that may be our children and grandchildren that have to fight. This isn't about hawks. This isn't about doves. This is about prudence. It's about judgment. It's about doing the right thing. Which then brings me to Joe Biden. You Democrats. You people in the media. You people in academia. You brought us Joe Biden. You knew damn well he was incapable of doing what a president needs to do. For a whole variety of reasons. You knew that he was not mentally fit to be president of the United States. You knew that experientially, he's been a disaster when it comes to foreign policy. You are responsible for the man who sits in the Oval Office today. You. You never Trumpers who have a hate on an obsession that requires deep psychological treatment. You are responsible for the man who's in the Oval Office today. As I speak, what is Congress doing about any of this? Nothing. They're chasing down Donald Trump and protesters. They're trying to change our voting system for the worse. They're trying to nationalize what belongs to the states. They're trying to create new entitlements for people who don't work and don't want to work. They're trying to redistribute wealth. They're trying to turn us into a radicalized France. Is that a good idea, ladies and gentlemen? No, I don't think it is. How many of our leaders have gone on television or radio and spoken to us truthfully in a straightforward manner about the threats that this country faces? And that's Russia and China. What about Iran? Iran is months away from having nuclear weapons. This is a regime that makes it abundantly clear what it intends to do to us, let alone the Arabs and our allies, the Israelis. You think we can ignore this forever? We have an administration that's bending over backwards, not just appeasing the Iranians, paying them, begging them to come to the table and agree to an agreement that they'll never honor. This is a regime that hates us. They are fanatics. They are zealots. They're not going to be persuaded otherwise. I mean, even mullahs with nuclear weapons, folks, are a threat. This is the situation today. You think America's ready? I think a significant portion of the population's ready. But I think a significant portion of the population is not. So as Joe Biden goes off last week and gets an ice cream cone, as if he's some third grader, and as his people go on TV trashing Republicans, as if they're leaders of the Third Reich, and as the media in this country, with so many low IQ, inexperienced, radical leftists dressed up as journalists, not just ignore the threat, fail to provide the American people with the context for the threats we face, we're not ready. We're not ready. You don't have to believe me. Just look at our enemies. the next day. If not the next day, maybe next year. They see the Biden administration as the perfect opportunity to act. The communist Chinese are going to act in one form or another. Putin is going to act in one form or another. I don't know what they're going to do. But they see the weakness in the Oval Office. They see the leadership of the Defense Department. Billy, who calls the head of the communist Chinese military to tell everything's going to be fine. Don't worry about Trump. We'll light it off if we attack. They see this. They see the pipeline between Germany and Russia and what Biden did. They see our budget when it comes to the United States military, that this administration and Congress are not serious. They saw what happened in Afghanistan, where there's still American citizens behind enemy Taliban lines, as well as our allies. They see our capitulation to the Iranian regime. They see it all. They see weakness. That's why I said over a year ago, who do you think our enemy's rooting for? President of the United States. Donald Trump or Joe Biden? I think the answer was obvious then. It's obvious now.
This is a waste of time. I have to try to remake these videos because I've got 4 videos that will not upload to YouTube. I don't know if the other channel, Miguel Everyone channel, has been, if I'm locked out of it, or is it somebody fucking with my phone again? Happens a lot. So I'm just trying to recopy them.
Have incredible resources and ability, and so they will be monitoring.
conversations that take place, not because they think, you know, the athletes will be talking about some great intel. They don't care. They have the resources to hoover up everything, and this is what they do, and then they sift through it later on to determine if they have something of value or not. So really, you know, if you're thinking about going to the Olympics and engaging in shenanigans, you know, the advice is just don't do it. Wait till to get out of country. This is not, again, something new. We've talked about this before.
Yeah.
But the Chinese regime, they are now the second largest economy in the world because for decades they have been stealing research and development. They have been stealing intelligence and economic information. And to the tune of $30, $40, $50 billion in damage to the U.S. Yeah. a year.
And they agreed to stop doing that.
Going to be
I think hard for some of my Democrat colleagues to, you know, accept the fact that she's ready to wage war on industries that are critical to their own states, and frankly, an industry that's critical to America. We've seen again inflation running at massive highs for four decade record highs for inflation. This is going to make it worse. So she uses, she debanks the oil and gas industry, and again, back to our national security. She makes us more dependent on other nations, again, that don't ever necessarily have our best interest at heart. That's going to be bad for our national security. So I think my colleagues are going to be listening very carefully today about what she says. I think we should be very concerned about this, you know, again, this use of the old Democrat playbook and basically weaponizing the regulatory construct here in Washington to get policies passed that the public
Yeah, well, you make a lot of good points. I find it extraordinary that President Biden continues to lean toward the extreme left and put up very, very progressive candidates, even though the public is rejecting his agenda. It's as if he's not listening to the American people at all. And you mentioned being reliant on foreign countries for oil and gas. How about Russia? I mean, President Biden is sending more than 3,000 troops to Eastern Europe right now. He says it's going to back up NATO allies with thousands more on standby for deployment. This marks America's first major move of U.S. forces in the Russia-Ukraine border scandal. The Senate will be briefed today on the escalating tensions between Russia and Ukraine. But what can you tell us now about this? Can you explain 3,000 troops going to Eastern Europe? Not one of them expected in Ukraine. They're not going to go to Ukraine. This is just for NATO countries, Poland, Germany, Romania.
It's just amazing, Maria. You've done such a great job of educating the American public about what's happening in our southern border. The Biden administration is unwilling to defend our southern border, yet he's willing to send troops overseas to stand up and protect another nation's borders. I think it's really preposterous when you look at it. And if you think about the number, 3,000 troops against 120,000 troops from Russia, this is nothing more than a messaging exercise. I think Vladimir Putin's heard enough messaging from the United States, from the Biden administration. We need to actually demonstrate our resolve and take action. And that sort of action needs to be in the form of sanctions. Sanctions now, not waiting till after something happens. I mean, you know, Vladimir Putin has benefited from sanctions being waived by the Biden administration already. Just look at Nord Stream 2. Congress has passed sanctions that the Biden administration has waived in his favor. We need to demonstrate our resolve right now to demonstrate American strength and sanction him now.
But everybody's saying the same thing, Senator, that the sanctions should go into place right now. I mean, what does Joe Biden say? I mean, I find it extraordinary, frankly, that the only leverage point the United States has is something Joe Biden gave to Russia 6 months ago, the Nord Stream pipeline. Is that all we've got?
Well, we have other sanctions that we can put in place, but I think that the major discussion here in the Congress right now is on the timing of sanctions, and there's a great deal of pressure on the Democrat side to make the sanctions only come into effect after Putin has acted. We need to give Putin a taste of what's to come, and again, I think it's critically important, Maria, that we finally step up and demonstrate American strength, American resolve, and that means imposing sanctions now. Nord Stream 2 would be a great start.
All right. Senator, thanks for your leadership. Great to catch up with you. Thank you, sir. Bill Haggerty joining us this morning in D.C. We'll see you soon.
Top of the news today, Joe Biden came to visit New York in the aftermath of the tragic deaths of police detective Jason Rivera and Wilbert Mora. Predictably fell back on the usual left-wing policies, namely gun control, federal funding for social services, a small increase in federal money for new cops. You know, the single best critique of the president came from my friend Heather McDonald in a brilliant Wall Street Journal op-ed piece, Must Read. And I will quote him: "Expect him to ignore the root cause of record-breaking violence, the demonization of law enforcement to which he has contributed. During his presidential campaign, Mr. Biden asserted that black parents were right to fear for their children's lives at the hands of the police." He said that. On April 12, 2021, the president tweeted about the need to address the trauma that black Americans experience every day from police shootings. During the National Peace Officers Memorial Service in Washington, he lamented that the promise of equal and impartial justice was denied in too many communities, black and brown, and that too many families are grieving unnecessary losses of their sons, their daughters, their fathers, their brothers from police violence. He said that.
Unbelievable.
The problem isn't control laws in the country. The problem is, New York is one of the worst crime.
It's all over. It's all over,
no
people.
Jail, no jail.
It's all done.
Everybody plays each other. They're all playing off of each other. Giuliani was in charge. Don't forget, Giuliani was in charge, mayor, under the biggest false flag that we've ever pulled off in the United States. One of the biggest. Wasn't even the biggest, but in my lifetime, it was definitely one of the biggest. There's so many others that are so bad that you won't even believe it, you know. Candace was on saying something about the Indians that were eating people, they were cannibals. And the thing is, I'll try to talk about it more in future videos. When I know my videos are sticking, I'll talk about it more. But, yeah, I was explaining in one of the other videos that we do that today. We still do that. Nobody's thinking about things the way that they are. They always follow their programming. They won't actually admit it. But I was trying to give examples, and the video cut me off. But, you know, we sacrifice people all the time. So as I'm listening to Mark Levin talk, or I'm listening to this guy Larry talk, or anybody else on the news, I'm just doing it to fill some videos, see what's going to pass, doing background, and then here and there I'm shooting the shit a little bit. But when you look at that statement that Candace made on that other video about that, alright, like today we got 350,000 a year that die of cancer, children, this is children, because she was upset saying that there were brown people that used to at one time were cannibals, and still is today, for that matter, but she was saying it was more of a regular thing. First of all, she's going, Candace, I'll talk directly to you, and I'll pretend that you're going to someday come to these, which I doubt, because they'll probably be all shut down by the time you even come to them. Alright, stem cells from aborted fetuses. We use stem cells from aborted fetuses for a lot of things, and we've been doing it for a long time. They told us back in the 70s that X and Y chromosome was going to be put into vaccines for babies and stuff like that, which was a little bit strange, because if you're a boy, why do you need extra? Either way, you don't need extra, but for some reason they feel the need. Well, how do you think they do that? What do you think they're using to do that with? They tell us that that's stem cells, right? What do you think they're getting the stem cells from? Right. So isn't that the same thing as, you know, eating their children, sacrificing and eating their children? It's the same fucking thing. Now, I can get more conspiratorial and talk about it in a lot of other places that we do this. Eating animals is besides the point. That's like a whole nother level of it. But humans consuming humans, we do it in many, many ways. It's going to sound very conspiratorial to you. That's only one example that I can give you that maybe could help you understand. Right there alone, if you're using stem cells from aborted fetuses and then pumping them into generations and generations as we go along, because, see, I'm trying not to say, because I don't want my videos to get deleted, but there have been recent times, very recent, like in the last 2 years, I won't say what the virus is, but there's been a virus that we didn't make a vaccine for, we just made something to alleviate the symptoms, and in doing so, you cannot know what the ingredients is for under contract 55 years, but a couple things do spill out here and there of what is in these shots, vaccines or shots. We call them vaccines for some reason. But yeah, they also have stem cells from aborted fetuses in them. So if you got, let's say, right now we're at 80% of the United States has all taken the shot, right? So that's 80% right there. I mean, it's no big deal because we've already been doing it, like I said, in other ways anyway. But that's just the way that we're doing it now. So there's, guarantee you, 80% of the people all just took some amount of aborted baby stem cells. So, so yeah, it's not going in our mouth. We're not chewing on it and swallowing it. Okay. You know, does that make you feel better? But as far as us sabotaging our own selves and fighting from within and breaking up the country, like I'm telling you, and everything, that it's a given. Everybody should know this. I don't understand why anybody's even acting surprised. This was the plan. This was the time limit. This was the time frame they planned on. And all that shit. So, gotta put the mouse in here, I think. Yeah. So, Mark Levin talking about the wars. And this guy talking about the wars, it made me think of what I was saying in the video I did the other day about it. that's another way we sacrifice ourselves. I mean, we send our children off to these wars. Nobody thinks about them. I'm listening to Mark Levin talk about how bad Russia is and how bad China is. They definitely are, but so are we. I mean, do we not look at ourselves and say, okay, well, over the last 20 years, right, go back to the lion mama conas that we're talking about, weapons of mass destruction under Bush Jr., because Bush Jr. wanted to get Saddam Hussein back for fucking with his father, right? Saddam Hussein didn't want to play games with America anymore, so America was all planned out. I mean, we knew that for the next 20 to 30 years, we were going to be slaughtering by the hundreds of thousands Eastern Indians all over the fucking place. So we started with the Iraq, right? That's where Bush Jr. went into. We're going to take Saddam down. He's got weapons of mass destruction. Killed hundreds of thousands of innocent people. They were not fucking all soldiers. That was bullshit, and you know it. We all know it. So we watched that happen. And, you know, this is the same thing I was talking about with the racism stuff. You have to bypass your mirror neuron. In order for you to send your children off to a war that you know is bullshit, to die in a war that's bullshit, and to take more than life from what they need based on lies, right? Because all those things have to happen. Parents have to say, all right, go ahead, son. Nowadays, go ahead, son or daughter. Because now we've changed all that shit. When you watch the history, how we fucked ourselves so badly, you know, women's civil rights and all that kind of shit. Those were presidents' wives that were pushing all that through as we went along. It was all programmed. It was all programming for us. We should be able to look back now and see how big of mistakes all those were, because women were more in control from home, handling the household and the children, than they are now being in the workforce. It's better for the tax man. It's better for the tax man to get everybody and women out there working as well. But that's it. It's not better for the people. It's not better for humankind. And anyways, we blew the fuck out of Iraq throughout those years, right? Then you had Obama was another good example. I was just saying this to my uncle. When Obama came in, Obama was bragging after his first year how many hundreds of thousands of Afghanistans and Iraqis that he was killing already. They'll call them terrorists and they'll call them bad people. But here and there, they smile and they look at the camera and smile. And Obama's smile was telling us that he did it all with drones. So now you can take away... You don't have to bypass your mirror neuron about sending your children to die. That's the thing about this. You didn't have to on that one, because he was using drones to kill a lot of innocent people, right? So using the drones, you didn't have to bypass that mirror neuron for that. Just send your kids off, because the kids didn't really have to go. They just had to go there, fly the drones. Some of them did die, and don't want to make light of anybody that, you know, went into those situations, because, you know, they didn't know the shit that I'm showing all of you. But then again, you're all going to ignore it as well. All of you watching this are going to keep ignoring this. No one's going to start looking. No one's going to go look. Time, more and more time's going to pass, and we're running out of fucking time. Anyways, so there goes Obama. So Obama's killing hundreds of thousands. And the reason this conversation even came up was because, because of the Whoopi Goldberg shit. They should not have done this. This is all a game. Republicans are a little better at false flags because they have better actors and actresses. But every other incident that you see on the news is a false flag. Every other one, I would say, is probably a false flag. So that's a lot. And I don't care what side they're on, Republican or Democrats. They all put on a facade of going against each other, but they're all working for the same common goal. To lie to humanity, to lie to us. And even the ones that don't know they're lying, when I confront you with it and I show you what it is I'm showing you and you refuse to go look, that's how I know. That's how you get added to the 7.8 billion. Because you've been given a chance to see the system for what it is, and you're going to refuse it. You're going to walk away for whatever reason. Money, maybe you're famous, whatever. Who the fuck knows? And that's... It's very frustrating, but on I go. Here I go again, trying to fucking show everybody the system. And like seeing it explains it for me so that I don't have to put myself out there, you know, and then try programming anybody. I'm not trying to, I don't have to. You just have to go look for yourself, you know. I don't have to be a programmer in order to convince you of what I'm explaining. All I have to do is show it to you, and then you will see it. And as long as you're looking at it for what it is, and don't bring your programming into it, don't bring any programs into it with you, and you'll be fine. We'll all be fine if everyone did that. Okay, so then, you know, you come forward to all this shit with Afghanistan. Just recently, Biden goes and takes everybody out of Afghanistan, and nobody on the news, Republican or Democrat, nobody's talking about several things. One of them is this, and I'm going to bring it up real quick because this video is almost done, and this is to Candace again, to Candace. Okay, one thing is this. As soon as we pull out of Afghanistan, China went over and took over all the minerals. They got the contract for all the minerals, the finites, that we could have used to, if we had our own factories and we had the capability, which we don't, but if we did, we would have all the finites for the computer technology that everybody is now, you know, going for, which is all garbage, by the way. As I always say, it's all shit compared to using the risk. What they're doing is they're using a fake synthetic version of the system that I'm trying to show all of you, the real true system. The real true system is being used, but not by the 7.8 billion. It's only being used by a small few in order to keep the 7.8 billion zombies in line. You know, we'll call it weather. You know, we'll say it's weather. Every tornado, every hurricane, every forest fire puts up the carbons that are needed in the atmosphere to be pushed around. The trailing that goes on, what people will call, conspiracy people will call chemtrailing or geoengineering, the ones I call mineral streets, what I'm showing you in the camera right now, that's where all these are. These are all laid out by the jets. But there's other ways too, and they're the old-fashioned ways, which is industrially. We can do it through the industrial revolutions that are going on in China, Japan, other countries too. Even Mexico is having a small industrial revolution right now because they're not as big, but a lot of countries are. There are others too, but they don't do it with jets like we do. Russia is also having an industrial revolution right now. Russia's making a lot of things, but ours is over. We're done. We're going back to fucking bread lines and waiting in line. I mean, things are going to get really bad, I keep saying. Because nobody wants to go fucking look. We're all going to keep fighting with each other about all this shit when you can just look for yourselves and you'll see the whole thing. And we can just stop all the bullshit. No more fucking billions of dollars for outer space nonsense. No more billions of dollars for education that's false education. Teaching our kids false history. Teaching our kids fucking math that's useless. False fucking math. I mean, how ridiculous is this? All the sciences being garbage. I mean, it's all shit. It's all shit. It just brought you more fucking religions that you can't prove, can't see for yourself, can't, you know. And they tell you, oh, no, you can test it. Yeah, okay. So imagine all the murders and the deaths that happen from controlling the weather. So let's say you're going to throw a hurricane or a tornado or a tsunami. These are all controlled by humans. These are not controlled by nature. That's a fucking ridiculous even statement. But when I tell people that, they don't believe it. They just can't fathom it. They can't get their head around it because they don't understand that they've been lied to about absolutely everything they've ever been told. And they can't get their head around that. They don't believe it. No way my parents would lie to me. My grandparents, everybody. Yeah, they all lying motherfuckers. We all lying motherfuckers.
So, I can't get these videos up. I'm going to try again. We'll see what happens. I'll be right back.